You're listening to GIGI Radio, the one and only Christian radio show for teen girls, with your hosts, Esther and Steph.
Hi girls, happy Tuesday, it's Esther here.
Hey girls, and it's Steph, ready for day two.
Another morning. So Steph, I've got a question for you.
Oh, okay.
So have you ever shown sympathy or kindness maybe to someone who was hurting and you helped them even if you weren't sure or you didn't want to?
I feel like I have. I'm trying to think. Okay, so a few years ago, I was at the shop and there was this lady behind us and on the escalators. And you know when you try to get out of the escalators, it's a bit tricky and she was a bit she was a bit older. But you know sometimes people don't welcome your help?
Yes.
So I was actually with my niece and we sort of turned around and we said, oh, do you need help or do you mind if we help you? Or she was struggling a bit and she's like, oh, yeah, that'd be great. Thank you so much. And we did help her and it felt really nice. And then there's a twist to this story.
Oh, I don't know this story.
She actually goes, do you guys go to so-and-so church and is so-and-so your pastor? And I'm like, yes. She goes, oh, well, he's the pastor of our church as well, because at that time he had two churches.
Oh.
And so she's like, oh, well, I can't wait to tell him I met you. Thank you so much for being so helpful. And, you know, she was saying thank you so much. And, you know, we said goodbye and everything. And me and my niece were like, oh, imagine if she, like, would have gone struggling with this thing. We would have not helped her.
Or she would have looked at you and, you know.
Or if we saw her another day when we visited the church.
And when
for
you
some
could
reason,
have helped her. Would have been embarrassing.
Yeah. So that was really nice.
I remember years ago, would have been when I started my practice more than 17 years ago. And I did something, like I helped someone in a need. And then in the last 2 years, these people remember that kindness and they did it back to me. And I'm trying to, I'm racking my brains because at the time I was like, oh my goodness, that was years ago. How do these people even remember I did that?
Wow.
And it came back to me. It's such a, but it
was years ago. You helped selflessly, not expecting anything, but whatever you did really impacted these people.
Yes,
and they were happy to, like, repay it.
But I have to think tonight what it is because it's eating me. But anyways, so why all this about, you know, mercifulness and kindness? Well, it's got to do with the story today.
Today's devotional is from Josh McDowell's Youth Devotions from the YouVersion app. Andy and the Lion. The people of ancient Rome told the story of Androcles, a slave whose master was cruel. Androcles ran away and hid in the woods for a long time. He was happy to be free, but had a hard time finding food, so he began to get hungry and weak. Finally, convinced that he was dying, Androcles crawled into a dark cave and lay down to sleep. He was awakened by a loud roar of a lion that had entered the cave. Androcles thought the lion was going to eat him, but he watched in fascination as the lion limped in circles around the cave, constantly whimpering and occasionally roaring in pain. When the great creature finally lay down, Androcles approached the lion carefully. To his surprise, the lion allowed him to gingerly lift the injured paw. Androcles discovered that a long, sharp thorn had lodged itself in the lion's paw. With one quick motion, he pulled the thorn out. The lion licked the tender paw while Androcles still held it in his hand, and soon both man and animal fell asleep. The next morning, the lion brought food to Androcles, and it continued to do so every day until a band of soldiers came into the cave and recognized Androcles as the escaped slave. The soldiers arrested him and took him to Rome. In those days, runaway slaves were forced to fight wild animals in the Colosseum for entertainment of the people. After a few days in prison, Androcles was taken to the Colosseum. His guards dragged him out into a dirt arena and left him alone. He trembled as he heard the roars of a hungry beast. Finally, a gate was opened at the other end of the arena, and a mighty lion raced in, roaring and baring his teeth. The creature leaped upon Androcles in a single bound as the crowd watched in astonishment to see Androcles and the lion he had befriended roll over and over in the dirt in a happy reunion. When the crowd heard the slave story, they cried out for Androcles and the lion to be set free. and they were. This fable illustrates an important truth. Jesus put it this way, "Blessed are the merciful, for they shall be shown mercy." Matthew 5:7, NIV. The person who shows mercy to others often receives mercy back, while the person who refuses mercy to others is cheated out of many good things. It's just another way that obeying God's commands protects us and provides for us.
I like that. I mean, I know it's not a true story, but the illustration, it's actually beautiful.
I love it too. But let's have a break and we'll be back after this song.
Here at your feet, I lay my past down, my wanderings, all my mistakes down, and I am free. Here at your feet, I lay this day down, not in my strength, but in yours I found all I need. You're all I need. Jesus, Jesus, at your feet, oh, to dwell and never
there.
your feet, I lay my life down.
And that song was At Your Feet by Casting Crowns.
Okay, so we've talked about us showing mercy to others, but has anybody shown you mercy, Esther? Have you been the lion that's been taken care of?
Look, I'm sure I have been. I just can't think of anything at the top of my head. But in saying that, I do know that God has shown mercy to so many people. One of the people that he showed mercy to was Lot and his family. So I don't know, girls, if you know the story, but God said that he was going to destroy Sodom and Gomorrah. And he and Abraham had asked God to please protect his nephew and his family. And God showed great mercy. So what he did was he sent two angels to the city to get Lot, his wife and his girls right out of the city and all the family. But apparently the other people didn't believe, but Lot, his wife and family were able to get out before the city was burned.
Yeah. I mean, there's a lot of interesting facts in that story.
Yes. But yeah. God showed mercy there where he really didn't have to show mercy at all. So that's a good example that I can think of.
Well, that's all from us today. We hope you've liked this one. I really like this one. And we will get ready for prayer. Dear Heavenly Father, thank you so much for a brand new day. You've given us an opportunity to start a day afresh. And we ask that you please give us kindness in our hearts and our minds to show mercy to those, Lord, around us. Thank you so much because you showed mercy to us. And we ask that you be with our family and our friends and us today in this day. In your name, amen.
This has been GIGI Radio signing out.